Hi friends, today I am giving a lecture on optimal binary search tree in dynamic programming in design and analysis of algorithm subject. Optimal binary search tree is one of the application of dynamic programming. It is one of the important application of dynamic programming. Dynamic programming is one of the algorithm design method that is used for solving optimization problems. Optimization problem is nothing but a problem may require either maximum result or a minimum result. It depends on the given problem. So now we have to discuss about the application of dynamic programming is the optimal binary search tree. So this binary search tree is used for storing the identifiers such as for, while, if, do, switch, etc. Okay, suppose we want to search the identifier in an optimal way. For that purpose, we have to use optimal binary search tree concept. So in this optimal binary search tree, our main objective is to construct the binary search tree in an optimal way. So this is the example problem. So for this example problem, we have to apply the OBST and finally construct the optimal binary search tree. When the problem given successful probabilities such as P and unsuccessful probabilities such as Q and the given identifiers A1 to A4. Okay, so by using this data, we have to construct the optimal binary search tree. Okay, so first the given data, the successful probabilities so P of 1 is equal to 1 by 20. Next, P of 2 equal to 1 by 5. P of 3 equal to 1 by 10. P of 4 is equal to 1 by 20. So the successful probabilities are given in the form of real numbers. So these real numbers are converted into integers. First, we are observing the denominators. Among the denominators, 25, 10, 20, which has the highest denominator? So each and every successful probabilities is multiplied with the highest denominator. So among them, the highest denominator is 20, so that each and every successful set probabilities are multiplied with 20. So 1 by 20 into 20, so that is equal to 1. 1 by 5 into 20, so that is equal to 4. 1 by 10 into 20, so that is equal to 2. 1 by 20 into 20, that is equal to 1. That is equal to 1. So therefore, successful set probabilities P1, P2, P3, P4 is equal to 1, 4, 2, 1. Okay. In the same way, unsuccessful set probabilities. So Q of 0 is 1 by 5. Next, Q of 1 is 1 by 10. Next, Q of 2 is 1 by 5. Next, Q of 3 is equal to 1 by 20. Q of 4, so that is equal to 1 by 20. So, identify the highest denominator among the unsuccessful set probabilities. That is 5, 10, 5, 20, 20. Among them, the highest denominator is 20, so that each and every unsuccessful set probabilities are multiplied with 20. So 1 by 5 into 20, that is 4. 1 by 10 into 20, that is 2. 1 by 5 into 20, that is equal to 4. 1 by 20 into 20, that is equal to 1. 1 by 20 into 20, that is equal to 1. So therefore, unsuccessful set probabilities Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3, Q4. So that is equal to 4, 2, 4, 1, 1. Okay, next, the given identifiers. So that is A1, A2, A3, A4 is equal to C out, comma, float, comma, if, comma, while. Okay, so this is the given data. So by using this given data, we have to construct the optimal binary search tree. So this is the given data. Next one, initial conditions. Initial conditions. There are three initial conditions are there. So first one is W of I comma I. So that is equal to Q suffix I. Next one, C of I comma I. So that is equal to 0. R of I comma I, so that is equal to 0. Next one is formulas. First one is W of I comma J is equal to W of I comma J minus 1 plus P of J plus Q of J. So this is the first formula. Second formula, C of I comma J is equal to minimum of I less than K less than or equal to J. So C of I comma K minus 1 plus C of K comma J plus W of I comma J. Next one, third one, R of I comma J. So is equal to K. R of I comma J, that is equal to K. So first we have to do the initial conditions. After initial conditions are completed, then again we have to use these formulas whenever I and J are different. Whenever I and J both are same, then we have to use these formulas. Okay, so first step, step one. Mod J minus I, that is equal to 0. What is the meaning of this one? The difference between I coordinate and J coordinate is equal to 0. So that means whenever both I and J are same, so then we have to use this condition. So for this condition, we have to use the initial conditions. First one, initial conditions. So the identifiers are start from A1 to A4, and successful set probabilities are starts from 1 and end with 4. and the unsuccessful set probability starts with 0 and end with 4. So here we have to consider unsuccessful set probabilities that are start with 0 and end with 4. Now, so we have to find out mod j minus I equal to 0. Next one, mod j minus I equal to 1. Next one, mod j minus I equal to 2. Next, mod j minus I equal to 3. Mod j minus I equal to 4. Up to 4. Here there are 4 identifiers are there. Starting with mod j minus I equal to 0 and ending with mod j minus I equal to 4. The final solution can be obtained by mod j minus I equal to 4. So this is the final step in our problem, mod j minus I equal to 4. Okay, so first one, our objective is to construct the optimal binary search tree, that is T0K. Okay, T0N. T0N is nothing but T04. Okay, we have to construct the T04 is our objective. Here there are 4 identifiers are there. Because of that reason, T0N. So that N is equal to, here N is equal to 4 identifiers. So T0N is equal to T04. Our main objective is to construct the optimal binary search tree T0N, where N is equal to number of identifiers. There are 4 identifiers are there, so that T04 is the final optimal binary search tree. Okay. Mod J, next go for step 1. Mod J minus I equal to 0. So that means W of 0 comma 0. So that is equal to QI. I value is 0, that is Q0. Q0, what is the Q0 value? That is 4. Next, C of 0 comma 0. So that is equal to C of 0 comma 0. That is both I and J coordinates are 0. Therefore, C of 0 comma 0 is 0. R of 0 comma 0. So that is equal to also 0. Next one, W of 1 comma 1. So I and J both are same. Therefore, it is equal to Q1. What is Q1 value? That is 2. Next, C of 1 comma 1. That is equal to 0. R of 1 comma 1. That is equal to 0. Next one, W of 2 comma 2. So that is equal to Q2. What is Q2 value? Q2 value is also 4. Next, C of 2 comma 2. That is equal to 0. R of 2 comma 2. That is equal to 0. Whenever we are observing the I coordinate and J coordinate, mod J minus I equal to 0. 0 minus 0, 0. 1 minus 1, 0. 2 minus 2, 0. In the same way, up to W of 4 comma 4, C of 4 comma 4, R of 4 comma 4, we are taking. Next one, W of 3 comma 3. So that is Q3. So what is Q3 value? That is 1. Next, C of 3 comma 3, that is equal to 0. R of 3 comma 3, so that is equal to 0. Next one, W of 4 comma 4, so that is equal to Q4. Q4 value is 1. Q4 value is 1. Next, C of 4 comma 4, so that is equal to 0. R of 4 comma 4, that is equal to 0. So these are the initial conditions, mod J minus I equal to 0. So next go for step 2. step 2 is mod j minus I is equal to 1. Mod j minus I equal to 1. So the difference between I coordinate and j coordinate is 1. So that is W of 0 comma 1. So what is the difference between j coordinate and I coordinate? 1 minus 0, that is equal to 1. W of 0 comma 1. So whenever I and j coordinate both are same, we have to use initial conditions formula. Whenever I and j both are different, then we have to use this formula. According to this one, I value 0, j value is 1. So that is j value 1. W of I comma j minus 1. I value 0, j value is 1, 1 minus 1. And P of j, P j value is 1 plus Q of j, j value is 1. So that is W of 0 comma 0 plus P of 1 plus Q of 1. So W of 0 comma 0, that value is 4 plus P of 1. P of 1 value is 1 plus Q of 1. Q of 1 value is 2. So that is equal to 7. Next one. C of 0 comma 1. Here we have to apply these three formulas for each and every mod j minus I equal to 1. Here we are considering 0 comma 1 pair. So for that 0 comma 1 pair, we have to calculate these three values: W of I comma j, C of I comma j, and R of I comma j. So C of 0 comma 1, that is equal to minimum of I 0 less than k less than or equal to j. Okay, I value is 0, k less than or equal to j, j value is 1. So that is C of I comma k minus 1, 0. What is the meaning of this one? Here 0 less than k less than or equal to 1. K is greater than 0 and k less than or equal to 1. What is the meaning of this one? K is greater than 0 and k less than or equal to 1. So by observing these two conditions, k value is equal to 1. K is greater than 0 and k less than or equal to 1. So because of this one, therefore k is equal to 1. So C of I comma k minus 1. K minus 1 is 1 minus 1 plus C of k comma j. K value is 1 and j value is also 1 plus W of I comma j. I value 0, j value is 1. So that is equal to minimum of C of 0 comma 0 plus C of 1 comma 1 plus W of 0 comma 1. So that is equal to minimum of C of 0 comma 0, that value is 0, plus C of 1 comma 1, that value is also 0, plus W of 0 comma 1, that value is 7. So that is equal to minimum of 0 plus 0, that is 0 plus 7, that is equal to 7. Okay, next, R of I comma j. R of I comma j is equal to k, that is equal to 1. Okay, R of 0 comma 1, that is equal to k. What is the k value? K is equal to 1. Okay, next coordinate is increment I value by 1 and increment j value by 1. So this increment can be done up to whenever j is equal to 4, because n value is equal to 4. So then next coordinate is increment I by 1, that is 0 plus 1, 1. increment j by y, 1 by 1 plus 1, that is 2. So that is 1 comma 2 is the next coordinate. 1 is w of increment I by 1, that is 1, increment j by 1, that is 2. 1 comma 2 is equal to w of I comma j minus 1, I value 1, j value 2 minus 1, plus p of j, j value is 2, plus q of j, j value is 2. So that is w of 1 comma 1 plus p of 2 plus q of 2. So that is equal to w of 1 comma 1. W of 1 comma 1 value is 2 plus p of 2. P of 2 value is 4 plus q of 2. Q of 2 value is also 4. So that is equal to 4 plus 4 plus 2, that is 10. Next one, c of 1 comma 2, that is equal to minimum of I value is 1 less than k less than or equal to j. So that is c of I comma k minus 1, I value 1, k value. What is the meaning of k value? K is greater than 1 and k less than or equal to 2. K is greater than 1 and k less than or equal to 2. By observing these two conditions, k is equal to 2. So c of I value 1, k minus 1, 2 minus 1, plus c of kj, a value 2, j value 2, plus w of 1 comma 2, w of I comma j. So that is equal to, so minimum of c of 1 comma 1 plus c of 2 comma 2 plus w of 1 comma 2 value is 10. So that is equal to minimum of c of 1 comma 1 0, c of 2 comma 2, c of 1 comma 1 0, c of 2 comma 2 0 plus 10. So that is equal to minimum of 0, that is 0, 0 plus 10, that is equal to 10. So therefore r of 1 comma 2, r of 1 comma 2 value is k, k value is 2. Okay, next go for incrementing I by 1 and incrementing j by 1. So that is w of incrementing I by 1, that is 1 plus 1, that is 2. Next, incrementing j by 1, that is 2 plus 1, that is 3. Okay, that is w of I value is 2, j value is 3, 3 minus 1, plus p of j, j value 3, and q of j, q value is also, j value is also 3. So that is equal to w of 2 comma 2 plus p of 3, p of 3 is 2, plus q of 3, q of 3 value is 1. So that is equal to w of 2 comma 2, w of 2 comma 2 value is 4 plus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 7. Next, c of 2 comma 3, c of 2 comma 3, so that is equal to minimum of I value is 2 less than k less than or equal to j, j value is 3. Next one, c of I value is 2 comma k minus 1. What is the k value? According to this, k is greater than 2 and k is less than or equal to 3. So k value is greater than 2 and k value less than or equal to 3. So greater than 2 and less than or equal to 3. So by observing those two conditions, k value is equal to 2. K value is equal to, 3. So c of I value is 2, k minus 1, that is 3 minus 1, plus c of k comma j, that is 3 comma j value is also 3 plus w of 2 comma 3. So that is equal to minimum of c of 2 comma 2 plus c of 3 comma 3 plus w of 2 comma 3 value is 7. Next one, that is minimum of c of 2 comma 2 value 0, c of 3 comma 3 value 0 plus 7, that is equal to 0 plus 7, that is equal to 7. Next, r of 2 comma 3, so that is k value is equal to 3. Okay, next coordinate is increment I by 1 and increment j by 1. So that is w of 2 plus 1, that is 3, 3 plus 1, that is 4. So this increment can be done whenever jth coordinate value is equal to 4. Up to this point, we increment I by 1 and j by 1. Whenever j is equal to 4, this step is ended. W of 3 comma 4 is equal to W of I, that is 3, j minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, plus P of j, j value is 4, plus Q of 4. Okay, so that is equal to W of 3 comma 3 plus P of 4. P of 4 value is 1, Q of 4 value is 1. So that is equal to W of 3 comma 3. W of 3 comma 3 equal to Q3. Q3 value is 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is equal to 3. W of 3 comma 3 value is calculated in step 1. So that value is Q3. Q3 value is 1. So 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is equal to 3. Next one, C of 3 comma 4. So that is equal to minimum of I value is 3, 3 less than k, less than or equal to 4. So, by observing this condition, k is greater than 3 and k is less than or equal to 4. K value is greater than 3 and less than or equal to 4. By observing these two conditions, k value is equal to 4. So, that is C of I value is 3, k minus 1, that is 4 minus 1, plus c of k comma j, k value 4 and j value is 4, plus w of 3 comma 4. So that is equal to minimum of c of 3 comma 3 plus c of 4 comma 4 plus w of 3 comma 4 value is 3. So that is equal to minimum of 0 plus 0. C of 3 comma 3 is 0. C of 4 comma 4, that is 0. So that is equal to 0 plus 3, that is equal to 3. So therefore, R of 3 comma 4 value is equal to K is equal to 4. Okay. So up to this point, this step is ended. Because incrementing I by 1 and incrementing j by 1, whenever j is equal to 4, here j is equal to 4, so condition satisfied, so the step 2 is ended. Next, go for step 3, mod j minus I equal to